So I'll hold you as close as I can, longing for the day when I see your face again. But until then, God must need another angel around the throne tonight. Your love lives on inside of me, and I will hold on tight. It's not my place to question, only God knows why. I'm just jealous of the angels around the throne tonight, singing hallelujah. Didn't know today would be our last, or that I'd have to say goodbye to you so fast. I'm so numb I can't feel anymore. I'm praying you'd just walk back through that door and tell me that I was only dreaming. You're not really gone as long as I believe. There will be another angel around the throne tonight. Your love lives on inside of me, and I will hold on tight. Not my place to question, only God knows why. I'm just jealous of the angels around the throne tonight.
Thank you. I would like to start the proceedings by giving a short tribute to my grandfather. Everybody hearing me? My grandfather, Daddy Dudley, as I lovingly call him, will be greatly missed. Sorry. Daddy epitomized the spirit of unconditional love for family and friends, near and far. When in his presence, his smile always lit up a room, and my fondest memory would be spending vacation in Blanchichet's. His smiling face looking down at me, and the sound of his fingers strumming the guitar strings. His joy and passion was power music, and waking up every morning to the songs of his birds and mommy, mom, Granny Celia, as I used to call her, at his side drinking coffee. Daddy was hardworking, ambitious, loving, self-taught, and generous. His presence will be surely missed, but I know he is in a better place. May he rest in peace, knowing that he is gone, but will never be forgotten. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. Due to the fact that the maxi broke down with the persons who have to do the second and third tribute, I am trying my best to fill in. My dad, who was Dudley Gomez. To understand who Dad was is to understand what a father's love is all about. My father's second daughter, we have 9 siblings alive, but we know what a father's love was all about. We never went hungry, we never went without, and we were brought up in a way that if somebody died in our village, we were supposed to attend that funeral. Every Sunday, we were supposed to be in church. And that was how he brought us up. Daddy was self-taught in so many ways. Daddy is a musician, but he learned everything on his own. Daddy built his house, and he learned everything on his own. I remember Daddy teaching us to make blocks, and every morning we had our quarter of blocks to wet. And in the evening, you come and you take them off, and you put them aside, and you made another set. He made a special mold for foundation blocks. That was the father that I knew. I remember some years ago, I got sick. I had surgery, and I heard my father praying, and he's saying, God, take me, but don't take Brian. Leave Brian, but take me. And that was the type of father that I knew, that I love, and that I will miss.
Be my glory ever till my rapture. Let us pray. Listen kindly to our prayers, O Lord, as our faith in your Son, raised from the dead, is deepened. May our hope of resurrection for our departed servant Austin also find new strength through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated for the readings. First reading.
First reading, a reading from the book of Job, chapter 19, verse 1, 23 to 27. Job said, "Ah, would that these words of mine were written down, inscribed on some monument, with iron chisel and engraving tool, cut into the rock forever. This I know, that my avenger lives, and he, the last, will take his stand on earth. After my awaking, he will set me close to him, and from my flesh I shall look to God. He whom I shall see will take my part. Those eyes will gaze on him and find him not aloof." The word of the Lord.
The Lord's my shepherd, I'll not want. He makes me down to lie in pastures green. He leadeth me the quiet waters by. My soul he does restore again, and me to walk doth make within the path of righteousness. My cup overflows.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. I will tell you something that has been secret, that we are not at all going to die, but we shall be changed. This will be instantaneous, in the twinkling of an eye. When the last trumpet sounds, it will sound, and the dead will be raised imperishable, and we shall be changed as well. Because of our present perishable nature, must put on imperishability, and this mortal nature must put on immortality. When this perishable nature has put on imperishability, and when this mortal nature has put on immortality, then the words of Scripture will come true. Death is swallowed up in victory. Death, where is your victory? Death, where is your sting? Now the sting of death is sin, and sin gets its power from the law. So let us thank God for giving us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. The word of the Lord.
Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus exclaimed, I bless you, Father, Lord of heaven and of earth, for hiding these things from the learned and the clever and revealing them to my children. Yes, Father, for that is what it pleased you to do. Everything has been entrusted to me by my Father. And no one knows the Son except the Father, just as no one knows the Father except the Son, and to those of whom the Son chooses to reveal him. Come to me, all you who labor and are overburdened, and I will give you rest. Shoulder my yoke and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will not find rest for your souls. Yes, my yoke is easy, my burden light. The Gospel of the Lord. Job. Mr. Dudley, and I will call him that, because I'm accustomed to the name Dudley. I don't know where it came from. It might have an interesting history. Now, the family was given the opportunity to choose readings, and these are the readings I chose. And it's interesting to note they chose Job. Yes? Yes. And one statement there, this I know, that my avenger lives, and he, the last, will take his stand on earth. That's God. Will take his stand, the last one. And there we are, with the Paschal candle, reminding us of Christ, who is the beginning and the end, the first and the last, the God who is, who was, and who is to come. Job knew that. He suffered the death of his own family, tragic ways. We won't go into the details, but he suffered from that. He never, although he was tried, they persuaded him, his own wife too, and friends tried to persuade him to do battle with God. And Dudley's death, as a matter of fact, I should say, while he was alive, and the death of his wife, you know, the two shall be one. So he wanted to be with her. He wanted to be with her. And he didn't bemoan the fact. He desired it. But he's not going to undertake to do something terrible to himself, to be there. No. Like Job, he never surrendered the fact that his avenger lives and is there forever, God, through Jesus. But every time I go to carry communion, he would just share that sentiment that he wants to be with his wife in that place together. That means to be with God. To be with God. And so we just sang the Cremant version of the 23rd Psalm, "The Lord's My Shepherd." And Mr. Dudley certainly understood that in a very profound way. And so, while waiting to die, he was waiting to die, a deep desire. Now, who are the people who desire to die? And why do they desire to die? Well, Mr. Dudley is an example of one kind of person who desires to die. But will not undertake doing anything to harm himself. No. Will not ask to be euthanized by some medical practitioner. No. But he was waiting on that time. And he said, "My time will come. And when it comes, I accept it." So he accepted death, just like Jesus, even death on a cross. But God raised him high and gave him the name which is above all names, which Mr. Dudley proclaimed in his life. Yes. Maybe this might be his little secret. I will tell you something that has been secret. That we are not all going to die, but we shall all be changed. What is that? What's that secret? The secret is eternal life. Don't you believe in eternal life? Well, for those who may not want to believe, and I'm not suggesting that anybody here doesn't, but for people who don't want to believe in eternal life, strange enough, they believe in it. They believe in it. A simple example that I would give, you know, is that those very person will tell another, perhaps who is either a fiancé, someone in love, and so, "I will love you forever." You will always be mine. And the name, the word, always and never. What is that? Isn't it about eternal life? Do you want somebody to be kind to you only for a short space of time? No? You would want them to be kind to you, and you will say, always. What is that? Eternal. What is eternal? What is eternal? So the secret which he knew, and he will remind us today, is a belief in life after death, because Jesus is risen. That's life after death. As the Paschal candle represents what we believe, that we are all not going to die, we're going to live. Because life is not just only about the physical body. If without our soul, we are not going to be sitting down here today. So we need it. It's invisible, but we need it to be where we are right now, today. But that has an eternal regard, because that does not die. It is this that has, as it is, we will see, from dust and ash wednesday, we came, to dust we shall return. That will go. But there's something eternal about us. It is because of God and the breath that God had breathed in each and every one of us here. Well, that breath is God's breath and not yours, not mine. We depend on it. We depend on it. It's not just oxygen. No. It's not just the process of respiration. But life was given, and that is all part of the givenness of life that God gave us, which Dudley received. And he breathed it his last. He gave up his spirit to God even before he died. Because you will tell me, you know, you want the Lord to just take him. Yeah. He was not afraid, because he knew the death of the body is nothing to be afraid of. What to be afraid of is his sin. His sin. It will sound, and the dead will be raised, imperishable, and we shall be changed as well, because our present perishable nature must put on imperishability, and this mortal nature must put on immortality. And he did put it on before he died. He did. He believed in the Lord. His avenger lives. And our gospel text: come to me, all you labor and are overburdened, and I will give you rest. His burden was not just only the death of his wife, but his burden is that he couldn't be with her in the same way that she is. That was his burden. So he carried it. He carried it for many months until now. He carried it, that burden. But hear it, come to me, all you labor and are overburdened. He never took that burden on his own. He claimed it with the Lord, as I say, through the Lord, with the Lord, and in the Lord. So in other words, it goes on. Shoulder my yoke and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble at heart. You will find rest for your souls. Yes, my yoke is easy and my burden light. And so it was easy for him to carry that burden. he never fell into depression that would allow him to have to get medication for it. At least not that I know of. But it was a desire which he carried with him. And that desire was a burden, but a light one, because he knew at the same time with that desire, he will be with his wife where she is. And that's what we pray for, even in the funeral rites service itself. We will hear it. We will hear it. And we shall be with them forever in the next. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord. May he rest in peace. His soul and all the souls of the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. Let's all stand. God, the Almighty Father, raised Christ the Son from the dead. With confidence, we ask him now to save all his people, both living and dead. And for Austin, who in baptism has given the pledge of eternal life, that we now be admitted in the company of the saints. Lord, hear us. For our brother, who ate the body of Christ, the bread of life, that he be raised up on the last day. Lord, hear us. For all our deceased relatives and friends, and for all those who have helped us, that they may have the reward of their goodness. Lord, hear us. For those who have fallen asleep in the hope of rising again, that they may see God face to face. Lord, hear us. And for you, the family and friends of our deceased brother Dudley, certainly, may he be consoled in your grief, as the Lord himself wept at the death of his dear friend Lazarus. Lord, hear us. And for all of us who are assembled here to worship in faith, that we may gather together again in God's kingdom. Lord, hear us.
Lord,
eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord. May he rest in peace. May his soul and all the souls of the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace.
Amen.
Be seated. The collection now will be taken up. Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that your servant Austin, who has journeyed from this world, may by this sacrifice be cleansed and freed from sin, and so receive the everlasting joys of the resurrection through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
And receive thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, O Lord Jesus Christ, eternal Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as one alone he accepted death, so that we might all escape from dying, as one man he chose to die, so that in your sight we all might live forever. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, as with joy we proclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, God of hosts,
heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these as we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dew fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection.
resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Jesus our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember your servant Austin, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he, who was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our other brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to bequeath eternal life, and we praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen, 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 amen.
At the Savior's command and for my divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. And so offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, sins of the world, have mercy, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, sins of the world, grant us.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are you who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
sharing his life, we shared his love. One body of Christ, washed in his blood, the blood of the Lamb, his body alive, reunited in love, bonded by his sacrifice, living as one, caring as one, body of Christ. Though we are many, there's room at his table. He blesses us equally, sharing in body and blood. We share in his life, we share in his love. One body of Christ, washed in his blood, the blood of the Lamb, his body.
Your son, Austin, for whom we have celebrated this Paschal Sacrament, may pass over to a dwelling place of light and peace through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
As we gather to commend our brother Austin to God our Father and to commit his body to the earth, let us now express in song our common faith in the resurrection. As Jesus Christ himself was raised from the dead, we too are called to follow him through death to the glory where God will be all in all.
Oh, we must die.
command us, for we must die.
Father of Mercies, we commend our brother Austin in a sure and certain hope that together with all those who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you have bestowed upon him in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn towards us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise and help all of us who remain to comfort one another with the assurance of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our brother Austin forever. Amen?
Amen.
Because God has chosen to call our brother Austin from this life unto himself, we shall now commit his body to the earth. For deep is calling on deep. For we are dust, and unto dust we all shall return. Jesus Christ will change our mortal bodies to be like his in glory, for he is risen, the firstborn from the dead. So let us now commend our brother Austin to God, that the Lord may embrace him in peace and raise up his body on the last day. I invite you to say a quiet prayer now in your heart. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord. May he rest in peace. May his soul and all the souls of the faithful departed to the mercy of God rest in peace. Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the sorrowful. You are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people who cry out to you in their need and strengthen your hope in your lasting goodness. This we ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the blessings of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever and ever.
Amen.
This celebration of love is ended. Go in peace. May the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and lead you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. May the choirs of angels welcome you and lead you to the bosom of Abraham, and where Lazarus is born no longer, may you find eternal rest.
I'm walking on my way to the Lord, to my Lord, 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 to my Lord's house. I'm walking on my way to the Lord, to my Lord who's waiting there for me. So let's all join hands and praise the Lord. Bless the one Lord, 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 go to our Lord's house. So let's all join hands.
Can't be sad, I am a true self. Let's sing with my Thank you. I just heard you walking on the continent. Every crowding situation, always listen to the last voice.
The
last voice. That's Tony will tell you.
Yeah.
Jeffrey.
Watch all, yes.
Right here, so we can give you. Come on. Everyone who has a bird, can we make a nice line for a photo? Let's make a nice line for a photo. Everyone who has a bird already. Everyone who has a bird already, let's make a nice line. But that's a nice little family group. Okay. I just want a family group. Whoever has a bird.
Yeah,
inside the family photo. Go inside the family photo.
One more.
So, everybody. Yeah.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Tom. Accompanying me is Akil, who is your director of the Tampa Center. And most sincere condolences to the family, friends, and all the individuals that are here. With us, we have 10 women, and each woman has a great freedom from the trials and tribulations that we still need to sustain. So, as we release these gloves, we just like the comfort of everyone here to just shout the name, whatever name we hold dearest to our hearts, whether it's grandpa, dad, Austin, whatever his name was, or what we knew him best by, we'll shout that name, right? So on my count of three, just 1, 2, 3, Daddy! 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 Wow!
Got it, gone!
They'll make a little trip to the land of Ketchum.
Got birds.
Light refreshments in the cooler.
Hello, we had a mirror.